In the earlier description of data structures, we mentioned two terms that we have not yet talked about: interrupts and signals. Let's take a moment now to explain these concepts in a little more detail. Interrupts are events that are generated externally to a CPU by components that are other than the CPU where the interrupt is delivered. Interrupts represent basically some type of notification to the CPU that some external event has occurred. This can be from I/O devices, like a network device delivering an interrupt that a network packet arrived, or from timers notifying the CPU that a timeout has occurred, or from other CPUs. Which particular interrupts can occur on a given platform depends on the specific configuration of the platform, like the types of devices that it has, for instance, or the details about the hardware architecture and similar features. Another important characteristic about interrupts is that they appear asynchronously. That's to say that they're not in a direct response to some specific action that's taking place on the CPU. Signals, on the other hand, are events that are triggered basically by the software that's running on the CPU. They're either for real generated by software, sort of like software interrupts, or the CPU hardware itself triggers certain events that are basically interpreted as signals. Which signals can occur on a given platform depends very much on the operating system. So two identical platforms will have the same interrupts, but if they're running a different operating system, they will have different signals. Unlike hardware interrupts, signals can appear both synchronously and asynchronously. By synchronous, here we mean that they occur in response to a specific action that took place on the CPU, and in response to that action, a synchronous signal is generated. For instance, if a process is trying to touch memory that has not been allocated to it, then this will result in a synchronous signal. There are some aspects of interrupts and signals that are similar. Both interrupts and signals have a unique identifier, and its value will depend either on the hardware in the case of interrupts or on the operating system in the case of signals. Both interrupts and signals can be masked. For this, we use either a per CPU mask for the interrupts or a per process mask for the signals to disable or to suspend the notification that an interrupt or a signal is delivering. The interrupt mask is associated with a CPU because interrupts are delivered to the CPU as a whole, whereas the signal mask is associated with a process because signals are delivered to individual processes. If the mask indicates that the signal or the interrupt is enabled, then that will result in invoking the corresponding handler. The interrupt handlers are specified for the entire system by the operating system. For the signal handlers, however, the operating system allows processes to specify their per-process handling operations.